name's Justin Price, and I'm the creator of the BioMechanics Method, which provides corrective exercise education for health and fitness professionals. Today I want to talk to you about static versus dynamic assessments. Now both are great, but I want to talk to you about what we use in the BioMechanics Method to help you evaluate which assessments you use so that you can gain the valuable information you need to design proper corrective exercise strategies. Now, dynamic assessments would be something like a gait analysis or a multi-directional lunge where you're looking at the body or the person you are assessing while they move. Now, if you're great at corrective exercise and know what to look for, looking at someone move can give you a lot of information about what's going on with their body and help you identify potential imbalances. However, when a client is moving, it is very difficult for them to understand all the nuances of what's happening. If someone's walking, for example, it may be difficult for them to feel that their right foot pronates more than their left foot, or that their right arm internally rotates more, which causes the scapula to move, which causes their rib cage to rotate, which is why they're shifting more to their left foot, which is why they're supinating on their left foot. And see, you're getting confused already. So can you imagine what your client's thinking? So the dynamic assessment is good for you to get information, but it removes the responsibility of the program from the client because they're thinking, I don't understand what's going on. I know what, I'll just trust the trainer. They must know what they're talking about. However, here's what happens. If you, as a client, give up the responsibility of the program and say, the trainer now is 100% responsible for the program because they know what they're talking about, what happens if the program fails? Well, the client blames you because you were the authority. So if your strategies don't work, it was your fault. On the other hand, static assessments empower the client to understand what is happening. So if you start, let's say, at the foot, and you go into detail about, you know, what you see at the foot, you know, what a bunion might mean, what a callus on the inside of the big toe might mean, while you're both looking at the client's foot, and you're teaching the client what these things mean and how this is indicative of particular dysfunction and how that dysfunction relates to maybe the knee and so forth, then the client starts to understand the process and they become involved in what's happening. Now the good thing about when a client becomes involved is they are more likely to do their homework because they see a reason why they're doing something. And if they're more likely to do their homework, they're more likely to find success. So with the biomechanics method, in level one, we have a very structured structural assessment or a postural assessment to help the client understand what's going on with their body and also to help you understand what's going on with their body in a very easy format so that you can design corrective exercise programs that get the client involved. In level two, we then move on to the more dynamic movement-based assessments. Once you understand what's going on and once your client has moved from the structural static to then understanding how their body relates to their movement. So I hope that helps you decide what you would like to utilize in your corrective exercise strategies, and we'll see you next time.